Werner Paul, thanks very much for joining us. There's a huge focus at the moment on sustainability, livability, and that's coming from both the investment capital, but also from the cities. So what role do you play there in terms of ParkBee?
We believe we make a difference in making cities more livable. There are three pillars underneath that. The first, being the most important one, is space. Cities are getting increasingly more populated, and therefore space comes at a premium. So I find it difficult to accept that a lot of this space is used for stationary cars in streets, and especially in our European cities, where streets tend to be narrow and pretty, and you don't want them filled by cars, in the full knowledge that the available capacity in garages, but currently not utilized capacity, is sufficient to get those cars off the street by and large. So that is an aspect of our business model, which has far-reaching consequences for cities, because this space is well distributed by definition over the city and allows for much better uses of the space, such as the planting of trees, think of climate adaptation, but also a much more social function of the street, which has a bit been taken away by stationary cars in terms of playgrounds, benches, people actually meeting one another, talking to one another. So that I think you will find to be very high on the policy agendas of cities generally. So that space is important. A more practical aspect of our business model is the fact that we are looking to bring about a change of behavior by drivers. So we are creating a dense network in European cities of garages, and therewith drivers can trust us to offer them a secure and certain parking space near their destination, wherever that may be. Now, that's something new. There are no such dense networks in existence. And with that density comes the change of behavior. Rather than going from A to B, people would then go from A to a garage near B. Now, the importance of that to the city is that there is no search traffic required. You with your Waze or Google Maps, or otherwise, you drive directly to the spot near B. And depending on which research you believe, that saves you 10 to 15 minutes of driving per car looking for a spot. And that is substantial if you add it up on traffic within a city. And the third point is about EV. EV charging is a often discussed point, and I think most of the propositions focus on roadside charging. Providing for the infrastructure in cities is a major challenge for those cities. And what we see is this under-utilized capacity, especially at night. By and large, these garages are empty. So what we want to do, and I foresee that becoming concrete in the course of this year, is that we provide for a large number of connections in garages so that it is not dependent on people moving their car, but they can just stay there overnight. And that makes it possible to do it at a lower voltage, which in turn is much more friendly to the grid. So that does away with the need to upgrade the grid, which is immensely costly for, again, those same cities. The people benefiting there will be the city dwellers. And if you live in a city, it is not easy to be certain of a place to charge your car. And that is a major blocker for people acquiring such a car. So in this manner, we believe we can stimulate the acquisition and use of electrical vehicles in cities. I don't think there's any need to explain how that contributes to a more livable city.
No, I think it's a really interesting initiative, really interesting strategy. I'm interested to see how that's going to develop over the next next couple of years. Thanks very much for joining us, Werner Paul.
Very good to be on your show.